Hi, and welcome to the Unguendo Guitars Workshop. My name is Daniel, and in this episode we're going to take a look at how to fix a torn out stud of a floating tremolo style bridge. A client of mine brought in his guitar, and apparently it has a crack in between the pickup cavity and the post that's holding the floating bridge in place, causing the bridge to move forward. And my client experienced all kinds of tuning problems, intonation problems, and you name it. Although I'm not a very experienced guitar repair guy, because I make guitars, I often get questions if I could also repair and maintain guitars. And yeah, well, of course I can. And this problem in particular I found very interesting to cover in a video, because this can also happen to you when you're making your own new guitar. When you have too little wood in between your pickup cavity and the hole where your threaded insert is going to go when pounding in the insert, you would not be the first that have the little ridge of wood crack when building a guitar. And most likely you will need a similar or maybe exactly the same repair as I'm going to attempt on this guitar. So let's first strip this guitar, take off the strings, take out the bridge and the pickup, and investigate the problem. As we can see, the guitar already had a repair at one point. There's a piece of veneer stuck to the inside of the pickup cavity in the hopes to strengthen this very thin section of wood. But as we can see, the repair didn't help because the stud still moved forward a little and probably, yeah, glued into place. So that's the first thing I'm going to do. I'm going to remove the old repair and try to remove the old threaded insert. First thing I'm going to do is remove the threaded insert, and it's glued in place. So I'm going to take my dedicated soldering iron. This is a soldering iron dedicated to heating up parts to loosen the glue. Don't use your good soldering iron for making the electrical connections. And I'm going to put it just in the threaded insert to heat it up and hopefully loosen the glue that's used on the old repair. I just leave the soldering iron in the threaded insert for a couple of seconds and wiggle it around a bit until I see the insert move, and then just pull it out. And here's our threaded insert. Now let's remove the piece of veneer on the inside. Again, using the soldering iron to loosen up the glue. And then carefully use a chisel to hopefully remove this bit of wood. So that came away quickly. Bit of cleanup to do. And now let's deal with this little bit of torn out wood. Next, I'm going to very carefully remove this broken out section of wood. Oh, it's very loose. I'm going to flood it with some wood glue and glue it back in place. And I'm using just regular tight bonds, nothing fancy, and I use a big cocktail stick to make sure the glue is spread evenly across the entire break. I'm I'm going to put a clamp on it. And before I can do the next step, I have to let this cure for a couple of hours. I let the glue dry overnight and it's now nice and solid. And my initial idea was to use a dowel and drill a new hole, insert the dowel to reinforce the tear out. But as you can see, there's too little material in between the hole and the side of the pickup cavity for the dowel to fit. And if I moved it further backwards, the dowel itself would be too thin to hold the force of the threaded insert. But in general, using a dowel to fix a misdrilled hole or to reinforce a hole is a very good idea. So if you have more material in between your hole and the pickup cavity, you could insert a dowel to reinforce the tear out. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to take a regular bolt, put in the hole, apply some pressure, and see how strong my glue joint is. In theory, it should be stronger than the original wood. And I really can apply a lot of pressure on this bolt. So I reckon the glue up job was sufficient enough. So now that I know that my repair should be strong enough, was very easy, I'm going to use a drill bit and a cordless drill and clean up the hole. So after cleaning the hole, it's time to put in the threaded insert. And I'm going to very gently tap it in with a hammer. So it's nice and flush. I'm going to clean the guitar a bit, try to hide the two little cracks with a tiny bit of super glue and polish it, and then of course reassemble the guitar. When making a new guitar and you're working on your body, I recommend to first route and drill all the holes and cavities required for your tremolo system, then insert the threaded insert, and only after that determine the position of your bridge pickup and route this cavity, and keep a minimum of about 10 millimeters of material in between the edge of your pickup cavity and the side of your threaded insert. And this should prevent any tear out during insertion of the threaded inserts and during the lifespan of the guitar. And to hopefully hide these little cracks, or at least fill them up, I'm going to use some medium viscosity super glue and just apply it with a toothpick and let it dry for about half an hour. So when the super glue has cured, I use a sharp blade to very carefully scrape away the excess. And when I'm happy with the result, I'm going to polish this a little, and most of it will be hidden underneath the pickup rig anyway. And then we should be ready to reassemble the guitar. The guitar, I'm just going to use a bit of lukewarm water, so just warm water, and a bit of very mild hand washing soap, and it's in a little bottle with an applicator, not too much, and use a microfiber towel and just clean the guitar. And this is fine for a heavy lacquered guitar. Nice and clean again. Some new strings on the guitar, and of course I'm going to use Elixir strings like on all my guitars, and I'm not sponsored, endorsed or affiliated whatsoever with Elixir strings. I just think these are very great quality strings, and they do as they promise. They give you a very clean, crisp, long-lasting tone. And ever since I started playing guitar over almost 30 years ago, I started using Elixir strings the first time I heard of them, and I never changed to anything else. So I can really recommend you guys giving Elixir strings a try. 0.09 to 46 strings on this guitar. See? Let's string her up and see if the repair holds, which I think it will. Quick couple of things I want to talk about. First off, why I leave all these strings so long and dangling. That's because maybe I need to take the strings off again, and having the extra length makes it easier to restring the guitar if necessary. I will snip them off once I'm done. And I can clearly see now with the guitar almost in tune that I need to spend a little more time on setting up the bridge and maybe the entire guitar, and that's beyond this video, I'm afraid. So yeah, let me work on this guitar a bit more and I'll be right back. And here I'm setting up the guitar, and of course with the guitar in a playing position, do some test playing, some intonation, and make sure the guitar is set up as best as I can. Yeah, the guitar is set up and the repair seems to be holding, so I'm very happy. Time for a final clean of the entire guitar before I can call my customer so he can come and pick it up. And now the guitar is really ready to be returned to its rightful owner. So yeah, I hope you liked this video. It's been a bit of a different video than you might be used seeing on my channel, but I hope you liked it nonetheless. Like always, if you have any questions, suggestions, comments, let me know in the comment section down below. And I have to say, it gets harder and harder for me to reply to each and every comment. I do read them all, but it might happen from now on that I don't reply to each and every comment. But be assured, I read all the comments and I appreciate them very much. So yeah, keep them coming. I really like reading through all the comments. Speaking of questions, I plan on doing a Q&A in the upcoming video, or maybe the video after. So if you have any questions you want me to answer live or in the video, yeah, please also let me know in the comment section down below. But start your question with Q&A or question Q&A or something that lets me know you want to answer, you want me to answer it in a video. Thank you very much for that. So yeah, if you have any questions for a Q&A video, let me know also in the comment section down below. I really appreciate your input. That said, I hope to see you all in the next video. But until then, have a nice week.